now we are doing with gospel living international, it's going to transform you first, and then people around you and the entire nation. Like you said, focusing on what you want to experience and what happens with your scans, that's what we are doing. So why I want to highlight health issues is because our physical body is a complete expression of who we are. You understand? It's a complete expression of who we are. And the first thing that we are going to discuss is intuition. Intuition. It says something about superconscious mind. It says something about gates, opening up the gates for success. And God said that the gates I open, no one can close. And the door I open, no one can also close. In the Revelation. So, but there is a way you will live your life, you will completely free from all those frustrations and all those things that make people feel that we cannot succeed, or maybe our country cannot succeed. You understand? So that is why I want to mention this first one, okay? This first one, intuition. That's the word, right? There is a relationship between your health and your intuition, and that relationship is expressed in a part of your embodiment called spirit. This your physical body, you're looking at, is like a container. Like a container that is contain a spirit that thinks. The function of the organ of that spirit is called intuition. Now, let's say that this is your spirit, and now this is your physical body. This your physical body is a container that contains a spirit that thinks. There is an organ in this spirit called intuition. Intuition. There is another organ called conscience. So anything that is happening in this spirit, this particular organ, the intuition, it affects its conscience. So if you're coming from a negative intuition or inspiration or revelation, what happens? It makes your conscience to negative. Then at the end of the day, you discover that it will affect another part of your embodiment or emotions. All these things originated from the center. You understand? So now, this lecture is to help you see clearly why sometimes we first rush to hospital without examining conscience. People first they rush to hospital, you know, there are so many disasters in our world. There are, you know, tsunami, you know, flood, and so on and so forth. So you that are here now, the purpose of this is not just to, you know, have a proper understanding of your physical health, but you can also look at the environment in this form and be able to solve the environmental challenges, not just your health challenges. You understand? Because everything happens for a reason. So if you understand this center, it will be easy for you to fix any other, you know, effect that you're seeing in the outside. So imagine where you're supposed to draw water pool in a waste bin and you brought it on the road. What happens? You're polluting the environment. Imagine if this chemical is supposed to be used for something and you're, you know, polluting your body with the same chemical. What happens? You're polluting the bodily environment. So, and you will see results. That is how it is in terms of your spiritual content. So it is very, very important that anytime you feel pain in this physical body, you understand? Anytime you feel pain in this physical body, you go straight to the conscience and understand what is happening in your conscience. The duty of this conscience is to examine what is going on here. Is it coming from the positive world, like you said about kingdom of light and also kingdom of darkness? Are you following? We are going to learn so many things about faith, good health, and the original health. So now, the level we are now is when you examine what is happening here. The easiest way to understand what is happening here is the duty of this conscience. So, most of us, most who have not been introduced to the life of the Spirit, we can't make use of our conscience at all. So, at the purpose we talk about making use of your conscience and growing your spirit is because it will help you to know when pain and pleasure are coming just because of what is happening in your conscience. So there's a relationship between your conscience, your emotion, and the physical senses. Are you following? There is a relationship between your conscience, your emotion, and the physical senses, where we see the sense of pain and pleasure. So if there is a pain, or, you know, distress in any part of your physical body, check what is happening in your emotion and also what is happening in your conscience. All these things have been proven scientifically. Okay? If you have emotional crisis, you will affect your physical health. It will affect your community. I like the way my brother highlighted on the issue of frustration. I want to use that one as an example. Before I close this issue of frustration. Frustration, you know what is frustration? Frustration can actually make it a strong matter. Are you following? Frustration comes, is the emotion that, you know, is always straight up that if you go here, there is no success, here, there is no success, you know, because every door is closed. So that mentality can drive people mad, So what happens? Some people will not go as far as committing suicide. Let's say for instance, if I'm an actor, maybe a Hollywood actor, and I'm successful in terms of cash, and have so much money in my pocket, you know, and have houses, and I have everything that you can think of. Then why is it that most of the time, you know, have the urge to commit suicide? Why? Are you not getting it? So you cannot understand the effect of this conscience. Because it's not about having so much money in your pocket. It's not. There is something deeper than what you think. That is why we talk about conscience. There is a way you can have so much money in your pocket without affecting your conscience. So the reason why people have so much money in their pocket, their conscience is already polluted, they have so much frustration, that is emotional crisis, and they suffer a lot of pain. That's why they want to give it up, they want to give up life. Because the pain is too much. They are too much in the body. There has been good things, like I said, some of these pains we have in the body is a result of what happened to the emotion. The emotion is just an organ in the soul that, you know, detects how we are feeling, whether we are feeling good or we are feeling what? Bad. So the more you feel bad, the more you can suffer most of the, you know, emotional crisis that people suffer. So I'm just taking frustration as an example. I'm not telling you the reason why a lot of people are going to suicide. Even the start of it, I'm taking it, and it's very, very common in our world. So now, there is no need talking about the life-giving solution. Bitterness. And anger. All these things are emotions. But why I want to use this train to help you is that there is something very, very powerful about the opposite of all these three things. Who can tell me the opposite of forgiveness? It's opposite of unforgiveness is forgiveness, right? Yes. Opposite of bitterness is what? You can see happiness, right? Opposite of anger, can say passion or excitement. Let's say passion. All right. Forgiveness. And then happiness. Easiest way to enjoy every positive emotion is to understand the concept of that word, love. Are you following me? That word, love. We have thousands of emotions or thousands of sickness. We're not going to go into all the different emotions. Emotional crisis, frustration, anger, bitterness, unforgiveness, you know, people of gratitude, so on and so forth. There are many, but they're not. So summarize them. If you know, we talk about love, we don't really get it. We think we have heard so much about love, we know so much about love, but we don't get it. If you understand the concept of love, it will be easy for you to graduate from any negative emotion that you're facing to a positive emotion. So that is why we talk about the order of love, the relationship in this order of love. We teach people that come one at a time, having a time every day for the maker of this world, the author of God, is our heavenly Father, the man of God. That is the easiest way your life can now be consumed with this agape love. That's the easiest way, very simple. Very, very simple, because the vibration will be flowing from the center. You are relating with the creator of your spirit. So it will be open up from the center like water of life. Every day you have time with God. Every day you have time with God. It's not the normal way we use to have time with God, pray, asking for heaven and earth. No, that's not what we teach. For you to have a very sound conscience, sound emotional, and, you know, physical body, you need to understand that He is a being that, you know, wants companionship, wants love. He wants you to listen. One of the things we are seeing in the whole Eastern States, especially when we meet people who are angry, and they have attracted a lot of angry people, and they believe through this anger they can solve so many problems. It's not really the way you see it. It's not really the way you see it. You know, when you move away from the relationship with God, the next thing is you look at problems and the things we need to ask God, give me this one, give me that one, no. Give me this. No. We are talking about relationship with the man of God. He needs you to not sit down and do what he is doing to you. Does it make sense? Not the conventional way we do in the church. Ask for healing, ask for wife, ask for husband, ask for money, ask for this, that, and that. If I have you as my friend, and anytime I see you, the next thing you tell me is, please, I need this one. Will the friendship grow? It will not grow. You
You know, but that's why we keep talking about having time with God every day. And why you say covenant is because when you have a particular time, it's a covenant between God, is always there waiting for you. It's more serious than you. It's the one that will teach you how to be serious with appointment. It's a time of appointment with him. And the reason why we encourage people to use Bible while growing your intuition capacity is because it makes you to focus in the up-to-date or every other problem you're thinking about. It makes you to focus. When you're studying Bible, the Word of God helps you to focus so that easily you can hear God's word. Alright, having said that, now, like I said before, so the reason why this man will commit suicide is a thing of the mind, because this intuition flows also to another level in the so-called mind. So, it doesn't matter the way that that person or who is an actor or whatever has made his money. But if something is wrong here, something will be wrong in the conscience. And you can see, before the people manifest this emotion, there's a relationship between this intuition and the conscience. Also, there's a relationship between this mind and emotion. Because as a man thinks, so it is. So what is happening in your mind is what reflects in your emotions. So it's a thing of the mind. So if you see yourself, whatever world you have passed through, you can be renewed just because there is a renewal in this your mind. There is a shift in the mindset. There is a new life you're visualizing. There is a new life. You know, one of the things I enjoy when I do this one that time, he presents a picture to me every day. And it's so wonderful that anytime I dwell on this picture, you know, obstacle is just a small thing for me. You understand? So it's a thing of the mind. It's a thing of the mind. So now, I want to hear this so that I can draw the next thing from here. It's a thing of the mind. So now, if you look at your entire body, and scientists were able to prove that there is an endorphin, happy hormone, endorphin. It's called happy hormone. This endorphin is always in the backbone. It's secreted from the backbone. It's called happy hormone. Anytime this endorphin is too much in volume in your bloodstream, it promotes longevity. It boosts the immune system. It helps the immune system to be very, very powerful. So now, if normally people can contact disease somewhere in the world because of the level of endorphin, it makes your immune system to be very, very high. So now, that is why we need emotional awareness for us to maintain physical health. So now, I want you to look at your body also, the basic structure of your body, the basic structure of your body itself. Just the way this entire building is, you know, constructed with God. Our body is built with cells. So now, this cell is very, very important. Why? Because what happened in this cell determines what happens in the entire body. Because it's from this cell that we form tissues, organ, system, and also the entire human. So now if this cell is unhealthy, the entire human will be unhealthy. So as a wise person, if you can maintain good health in the level of cell, in the cellular level, what happens? The entire system will be healthy. This is the entire system. So now, I know that, like I said, this formula that we talk about is a product of three levels of knowledge. Intuition, which is revelational knowledge. Revelational knowledge. Theoretical knowledge, through research, and practical knowledge. So it's a combination of these three levels of knowledge. If you look at the first product that was created is brains. When God gave us that, give us our mind, like my brother said, in the other sexual realm. God didn't give us our mind, he gave man that. So, most times we pray, God give you the gift into your heart. You know, my people die because of lack of knowledge. My people, he didn't say those that played to be my people. He said, my people. So, these people are really God's people. And they die because of lack of knowledge. So now, God has given us so many things that he wants us to be aware. And thank God for helping us to get this formula in such a way that the oil that we lose by eating them in our daily life, in our daily, life, we don't lose it again through this progress. So the beauty of that oil is to make the cell in the world. And there is no preservative. The world started suffering global health crisis with the invention of God. That is why we have a lot of junk running out to the night. So as you eat this junk, these cells suffer. Instead of being healthy, they look weak and unhealthy. So what happens? The tissues will be unhealthy, the organ system and the internal organ will be unhealthy. So that's what happens. So now, the purpose of this formula is to make these cells unhealthy because it lubricates the cell wall, so that when you eat fruit and vegetables, there is what we call vitamins and minerals. Are you following? It flows in faster. So these vitamins and minerals make this cell to be what? Strong and vibrant. You never pump any ball and you stand on it and the ball not, break. Why? Because it's a strong ball. It can carry big weight. You know, if you bring so many balls, original ball and pump it very well. And place it as foundation. You can carry a whole building. Are you aware? You can carry a whole building. That's how our self is when we treat it, when we make it very, very heavy. So it will be very, very strong. Now, one of the things that we teach people is when you see opportunity, you understand, identify it. If you begin to train your spirit, you have the capacity to identify opportunities. I have seen someone, there's a story they told us about a man when there was a tsunami happening, I think, in China, in the top of China. So the government intervened and we were evacuating people there, and the man resisted. He said that God is going to take care of him. You understand? So they brought sheep, he refused, they brought, wood. He refused them. Even when the water is going to the upstairs level, they brought, Kaikonta, he still refused to join them. And that God is going to take. God gave him this environment. There's no way God will allow this environment to be destroyed or swallowed up. You understand? So, at the end of the day, he was helpless. So now, God has to, talk. I said, I sent you cheap, I sent you good, and I sent you their comfort. What else can I do? So, this garden is a wonderful garden, because it's by God. And you are being here, you're going to make use of this, not only for yourself, but for people around you, in the different nations of the world. Because what we have is just what the world last today is coming. So the reason why people suffer diabetes, arthritis, high blood pressure, and poor immune system is just because we lack peace in our world. The essential oil that lubricates these cells, which you get from this formula, is so important that because we don't have it enough. Some of our cells look like this. It's so important that the nutritional scientist calls the most important nutrient on earth. The most important nutrient on earth. So it's more important than the vitamins and minerals you get from fruits and vegetables. So that is why when the cells are unhealthy, even the vitamins and minerals to get complete and mental health, they will find it difficult to enter the cell. Are you getting it? They will find it very difficult to enter. When you take drugs, maybe when someone is suffering from malaria or infection or any other thing, the person gets taking drugs. The drugs also will find it difficult to enter the cell. Because when it enters the cell, that is when it can work. So, on the healthy cell, it's very, very bad in our system. So now, what happens is that when you have someone that, these four chronic diseases that I just mentioned, is what people suffer, especially when they get to 35 years, 40 years, and so on and so forth. So it's major pain that kills people, and we say it's old age. You understand? So now, imagine you, people are already escaping from this old age phenomenon. Diabetes, cancer, diabetes, and arthritis. Just because they started taking this on them. You already escaped it. So now, for example, this is Martin Achimova. He has been taking glucophen. We call it glucophen. Granel, because of too much sugar in the blood, vessel in the blood, the stream. So what happened is that at the stage, she was going bigger. Especially when you don't have enough money to sustaining it with insulin. Insulin is one of the things you inject into your system. It has an artificial way of holding back sugar, making sugar to be converted from sugar to glycogen. So, what happened? You started taking the corn meal, and then because of the volume of fiber in the corn meal, the volume of fiber in the corn meal was able to rack away most of the sugar. Today, she is always giving testimony and telling others, please go and pick up this company. God gave us this company. Go and pick it up. Especially those that have diabetes. Diabetes. So, secondly, when the company enters the system, it opens up the essential oil to repair the cell. So, something like pancreas that has already been damaged because of too much sugar begins to get a bad. Begins to get a bad. People know it comes back alive. And the person will live a normal healthy life, no longer looking for the feeding and the loss and all those things. So it's, for me, it's a big miracle. It's a very big miracle that people who have diabetes can count on this. And not only that, even every other aspect of their life will be helped. Now, something like arthritis, we suffer a lot, especially women, we suffer more than men. Women lose calcium, drink wound inside bone, drink formation of bone of the pelvis of the child in the womb, drink breastfeeding, and so on and so forth. But men don't lose much calcium like women. So it looks as if women suffer more arthritis in their old age. So what happened is that the corn meal here doesn't have calcium. But as soon as it duplicates itself, there are so many calcium that we get in our daily diet that is always surrounding all these weak cells. Sometimes they make people die off and they crystallize in the arteries of our blood, so our circulatory system. So when they crystallize, most of them combine with cholesterol and they make the blood vessel to be very, very narrow. So blood will be forcing itself. You can see now, they don't have enough calcium that will flow into the cell and be transported into the bone. And they suffer arthritis. In addition to that, they have developed high blood pressure. Are you following? Because when these things are, everywhere in the arteries, you have a very narrow artery, and the blood will be forcing itself to you. And that is why the person has. Some people develop atherosclerosis. You understand? In this physical body temple. Now, what happens with that? When the corneal enters the cell and lubricates it, most of this cell gravitate from this nature to this nature. And what happens? This calcium that I already made flow into the cell with speed. Do you get that? So that is why the person will feel immediate relief from the days. Like my mother, last when he took the oil, he took it only 2 days. 2 days. In fact, before she stand up from here to here, we have to hold her because of those tuberculosis. So it took him 2 days, and now she stood up, entered everywhere, and did so many things in the bathroom, kitchen, and so on. And I'm talking to you now, she's always climbing steps now. Nobody's doing it. So that is one happened. So now, one of the things you've done for her now also is that, having seen that her cells are wearing the pipe, the DP and the heart, but she also, this DP may not be the most heart challenge. Because what is happening in the heart, they are also narrow. So a lot of challenges and complications in the heart. They are the things we face, the things. So now, the love of God has visited us. And that is why I say, this thing has like a way of making the heart, the heart, to function better. Arthritis, DP, and good heart, healthy heart, healthy heart. Yeah. What we did now is we have another product which has fish and moringa, but the fish and moringa will come in instant soup. Because of the level of calcium in that one, we also send it to the car. And we do it to anybody that has, you know, arthritis. After making sure the person has taken enough coming and the cells are what we buy. Does it make sense? So now, another thing I want to use to encourage you is about the people that have taken it and they didn't know it has effect in controlling their weight. They have excess weight in obesity. Then because of the fiber, we realize that this fiber is what does most of the things in terms of helping the person to control excess weight. So when somebody in fact, that is one of the reasons why if you go to partner hospital, you see the product this coming again. It's because of what you give you. Someone is like your sugar level and then obesity. That is actually your best. So after taking it, the way you describe and the weight came down drastically. So it is a big miracle. A big miracle. And the power of this will not go to dwell so much on the issue of obesity. Because there are something else we are going to introduce to you. About the app will help you to, you know, manage your life in totality. Make your life free from stress. So this Adam Bank, I don't know, some of you know where is Adam Bank. There's a woman selling rice in that Adam Bank. That one is shopping to us, it has cancer. And then, you know, she has treated it for so long that there is a wound in the leg. So I now introduce her to this formula because I told her that the cancer is not responding to drugs. The system is already good. The immune system, you know, the immune system is one of our systems. I hope you are aware. We have skeletal system, muscular system, digestive system, reproductive system. So now I told her that your system is already good. Do you understand? Your system is already weak. So now she started taking it. That's how the wound fled on that 2 days. She didn't change blood. She was using the same blood. So a lot of people that have infection and they have treated it, maybe by the malaria, by the parasite, by the viral, and so on and so forth. When they start taking this formula, you know, maintaining the same drug recommended by the medical doctor, the sickness groups. So you can see the core cells, what it has caused in our entire universe. There are so many other stories. If you heard about different heads, you have said something about making yourself to the head. You know about Benghazi. You have so many experiences. Is a brain surgery. There's one of the examples he gave when someone that has challenged the brain and was taken all over the world until they called him. So you do plan to do the brain solid and remove the tumor. Very successful. Then after 4 hours, the guy started to convulse, only for him to discover that the cell is already back. Are you following? So he wants to go and get a normal food supplement, carry on in America over there, and put it in the system. Under 2 minutes, the convulsion and every complication stop. This is because they have the change, you know, the cell vibrance. So there are so many things we might not be able to exhaust. But while we are touching all these areas, we need to know the importance of making yourself healthy. It can make you to retreat from so many other things. So now, I want to conclude with this. Our brother talked about Project Ada, Project Who, Project Who, Ada. Ada was the project. Adam was a project of God. He said, of Adam was created by God. When he was placed in a garden, one of the wonderful gardens in the whole world, it was a beautiful garden, a powerful garden, you know, and was blessed with so many things. But now, this Adam failed in the project and he came from grace to what? Grass. So if I may ask, if Adam is a project of God, I want him to be lost in that blessings. No, not just follow me. I know some of us are very religious, and we don't want to sound as if we are, you know, we know it all. You know, God wants to teach us something. Say something about failure, doubling your rate of failure, or learning from failure. Or failing forward, not failing what, backward. Every time you feel as if maybe you have failed, you have this mindset that you have failed what, forward, you're moving what, forward. And then I say, Project Father, be God, yeah? It's a question. The answer is, be God, yeah? Why I say that you got it right is because He looks for every ways to teach us about improving ourselves. He devised other means. You know, initially, he placed this man in a wonderful garden. A wonderful garden. Any beautiful place in the world. And there's no place you can use to describe this garden. In fact, he there is just part of the love. When you talk about it, then you talk about love. Do you understand? Talk about love. You see? So now, he changed his pattern. And the next pattern he changed is now he what is working. Do you understand? He's working. And what was the next? The first Adam, who was the last Adam? Jesus. Jesus was not placed in a garden. He was born in a manger. In fact, he grew up. He has to earn everything that today is the thing of things and you know a lot of love, but he has to earn it. But Adam was bothered and pampered by God when he messed everything up. There's no appreciation. If you don't appreciate this shirt, if you do what? If you appreciate the value. Anything you have, if you don't appreciate the value, the love increase. So our life should be a dance of love, appreciation. It should be a dance of appreciation. So how every beautiful thing you have can be decorated with this skill of garden. Everything you have, no matter how little it is. You can see it as your own garden of fear. And what will happen is that, this is the last step. What will happen is that it makes you to appreciate in value. Because you now make use of those things. Like you talked about using your superconscious mind, using your intuition, using all the potential God has given us, all the promises in the Bible, then when you don't appreciate those things, you can't source them. You can't use them. You can't unleash your potential. There are so many potential that need to be unlocked. Not up to you and me. The burial ground is the richest place in the whole world. Why are people saying that? Because there are so many dreams that are buried in there. They put the dance of appreciation. The dance for where you took unlocking all those dreams. The life is full of ups and downs, not like a wave. Crisis, problem, crisis. But for you to maintain a balance, you have to understand the capacity of appreciation. You understand? So with this, I want to end with this. See your life as a dance of appreciation. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I want to round up with you because we come to a very, very important aspect of this solid.